Doctor Doctor, I feel like watching Operation Ouch.
Well, that's easy. You just need to go over to BBC iPlayer where they're all available.
I don't get it. Well, that was a fantastic Christmas lunch, Chris. And now to finish with the jokes.
You go first.
Doctor, doctor, I feel like a mince pie.
I've got some cream for that.
Brilliant work, Chris. That's very good. Now, what's your one? Come on.
Doctor, doctor, I feel like a Christmas bell.
Get a good night's sleep, and I'll ring you in the morning, is the right answer. Amazing.
Well, that brings us to our Christmas quiz.
It's Chris and Xand's Christmas dinner quiz. Let's have question one.
Why do Brussels sprouts make you toot?
Brussels sprouts contain a lot of fibre, and that gets eaten by the friendly bugs in your gut. They produce gas which makes you toot, but they also contain molecules called glucosinolates, which contain sulphur, and the sulphur ends up in molecules that make your farts smell really bad.
Yes! 1 point!
Okay, Chris, your question, please.
Why does having a massive turkey dinner make you want to curl up and have a nap?
I know, I know! Some people say that turkey, the meat, contains an amino acid called tryptophan, and that tryptophan is used by your body to make a chemical called serotonin, and serotonin is turned into melatonin, and melatonin is a chemical in your brain that makes your brain feel sleepy. And if you're sitting there thinking, yes, yes, Dr. Xand, that's exactly what I was gonna say, you would be wrong! In fact, turkey contains the same amount of tryptophan as chicken or beef, just about anything else. And that isn't the reason that you feel sleepy after a Christmas dinner.
Is the right answer, Xand. You get 1 point.
It's 1-4. Next question.
So why do you feel sleepy after a big Christmas dinner?
Okay, I think it's because when you eat lots and lots of food, your guts have to do a lot of work to digest it. They squeeze the food, and then your liver does a lot of work as well to store and process all the nutrients. And all that takes a lot of energy, and also, when your gut gets stretched, it sends a signal to your brain that tells you to rest and digest. And that is why you feel sleepy after a big meal.
Brilliant explanation, Chris. 1 point to you.
2-1.
Final question. Why is it that no matter how much main course you've eaten, there's always room for some pudding?
Pudding? I definitely fancy a bit of pudding.
Not till you've answered the question.
Right, Chris, the reason that it seems like we have almost a separate stomach for pudding is a thing called sensory-specific satiety. Your brain gets a bit bored if you're just eating the same thing, and the more different flavours and textures there are in the food, the more your brain tells you to keep eating it. So when you've finished your main course, which is lots of different flavours and textures in itself, then pudding is a whole other load of flavours and textures, the creaminess of the custard, the crunchiness of the pudding, all of them signal your brain to keep eating.
Sensory-specific satiety is the correct answer.
Well done, Xand. It's a draw.
Brilliant. Well, that has put me in the mood for some pudding. What I really fancy is some mince pies.
Where are the mince pies?
Honestly, they should be right here. Billy! Well, from me
and me
and all of us at Operation Ouch, we're all wishing you a very Merry Christmas.
And a Happy New Year.
Exactly, Billy. And a Happy New Year.
Oh, sorry. Too many sprouts.